This week, the HPT visits the Sierra Nevada Mountains in the biggest little city in the world. We are at Peppermill Casino Resort in Reno, Nevada. 220 players, one champion, and over $94,000 is waiting for the last man standing.
All right, folks, we're in Reno, Nevada. It's the Peppermill Casino. We're about to crown our newest Nevada State Poker Champion. Who's it going to be? Final table action's coming up next on the HPT.
They come from all walks of life, each with a story to tell. All they need is a chip and a chair. It's an open casting call for those who love the game. This ain't your weekend home game. This is the HPT.
Sit right down, put on your poker face, you with the big dogs now. Better bring your best game, talk trash all you want. To me it's all the same, you won't leave with much when you come in second place. I'm the one with the stack showing seven to the jack on Friday, mama, cause I'm sending you back. I'll be the last man standing with the money in my hand. I'll be the last man standing with the money in my hand. Last man standing with the money in my hand. I'll be the last man standing with the money in my hand.
Hello and welcome to the HPT, the tour designed for everybody, where anybody can win. I am Chris Hansen. By my side, as always, is Fred Bevel. And Fred, this week, Reno, Nevada, the Peppermill Casino Resort and Spa. I love this place.
What a week it has been here at the Reno Peppermill. We were part of Jen Harmon's celebrity charity event for the NSPCA. The Peppermill officially opened their $3 million poker room. A great field here at the HPT's main event, and I finally booked a win at the cash games. I think the biggest little city in the world might be good luck for me.
No, Fred, we're not out of the casino yet.
Good point. Good point.
Now, Jen Harmon's charity tournament raised a lot of money this week while we were here at Peppermill. Money for the unadopted animals of the great state of Nevada. And we have plenty to show you from that event coming up later on. The HPT's inaugural visit here to Peppermill Casino Resort Spa was met with open arms, a brand new poker room, and hundreds of players thirsty for HPT action.
And that thirst was quenched with a $314,000 prize pool. Just over $94,000 of that will be going to our newest HPT champion, who will also claim the Nevada State Poker Championship. There's a lot on the line as this field has been narrowed down to our TV Final Six, and these players are ready for the action. But the question remains, can they handle the heat?
Yeah, that's the thing, Fred. It's one thing to sit at a poker table and play. It's another when you know that millions of people worldwide are watching your every move. So let's meet the six players at our final table and then get right to the action.
In seat number one, this is Keith Ryan from right here in Reno, Nevada. He's a professional gambler. Chris once won $80,000 by doing a multiple pick six four different times in one day. Starts this final table with $910,000.
It's funny, that's actually my retirement plan. I just need a couple of those to come in for me. Sitting in seat two, this is John Norberg from Yuba City, California. Learned how to play poker from a tennis coach, of all things, and he is seated at our final table, $770,000.
Jesse Rockowitz is sitting in the three seat. He's from Pacifica, California, a professional poker player that is self-taught, and he's a pretty good teacher as he starts today's final table with $940,000 in chips.
In seat four, this is Gary DiBernardi from Bend, Oregon. He's a professional poker player as well. He's been playing poker for about 9 years, and his favorite person to play poker with is his mother.
And he's probably the biggest Ducks fan you'll ever meet. In seat number five, this is Tim West, another professional poker player from Los Altos, California. Loves to play poker most with his brother, Tom. He's been playing the game 7 years and starts today with $800,000 in chips.
And finally, in seat six, this is Daryl Dyer from Sacramento, California. Also a professional poker player. And Fred, you might notice his headwear. It's pretty interesting. It's actually a superstition. His mom made him the hat that he's wearing here at our final table.
Well, good luck to him and everybody as the champion will walk away with over $94,000. Everyone at this final table guaranteed almost $16,000.
It's our first trip to Reno. Huge success. Love the Peppermill. And we're ready to start our final table. So let's throw the cards in the air and play some poker.
There are almost 6 million chips in play, and Daryl Dyer is holding 26% of them with almost 1.5 million. The short stack is Gary at 770,000.
We start this final table with blinds at 20 and 40,000, 5K Annie. Make sure you check us out on Twitter. Our handle is at HPT Poker Tour. Is it called a handle?
10-4, good buddy. John Norberg folds ace 10 over to Jesse Rockowitz.
Jesse makes it 90,000 with queen 9 of hearts. And we're on Gary. Gary folds. Tim folds.
Two stacks of blues.
Over to Daryl.
Yeah, two and a 3 orange.
Jack 9 of clubs. Our chip leader in the small blind.
Daryl thinking of calling a raise with Jack 9 from the small blind. He'll be out of position for the rest of the hand if he decides to play.
Daryl's 24 years old from Sacramento, California, professional poker player.
He is going to, no, he is not going to make the call, Chris. He is going to re-raise.
Oh, boy. Re-raise. Makes it 225,000 to go.
Keith looks down at 5-6 offsuit with a raise and a re-raise in front of him. Obvious, that's going to go into the muck.
And Jesse will let his hand go, and so our chip leader is going to win the first hand of our final table here at Peppermill. More poker from the biggest little city in the world when we return. Welcome back to the HPT. We are at the Peppermill Casino Resort in Reno, Nevada. I'm Chris Hansen, and he's hungover.
One of the many things going on around the HPT's inaugural visit this week was Jennifer Harmon's throwdown event to benefit the NSPCA.
I brought my pet for the SPCA. Come on, speak, speak, speak. He's a good boy. He needs some training.
The stars of the media came out to play and help the no-kill shelters here in the great state of Nevada and the unadopted animals. And being since Fred here is a rescued animal, we decided to join in the fun, start our own team, and get in the game.
I gotta send my wife a text of a dog I want to take home.
I think our team's got a good chance. We're stacked, we're loaded, we got all the players we need. Strategy, we haven't really talked much, but I think we're just gonna play really loose, really tight, really aggressive. I like HPT finishing in the top two places.
HPT!
All right, we didn't pull that off very well.
That's all right.
We're gonna take this thing down today, guys. I think I'm allowed to have my coach sitting close by.
Greg Lang will not be the last man standing. I will give anybody odds, whatever odds you want. I'll mortgage the house. You can have the keys. Okay.
What are you predicting?
There's no way Lang lasts longest on our team.
Oh, that? No way. Lang will be the first out of Team HPT.
I already tried to get Blue Diamond Phillips in the trade.
Yeah, we tried
for
to.
Lang, Blue Diamond Phillips.
If Lang outlasts me, I will put his dirty sock in my mouth.
Ooh, that's a good one.
That's how confident I am that he sucks at poker.
We've got a lot more from the throwdown event to show you throughout the HPT, but right now it's back to the poker. 1.6 million in chips for our chip leader, Daryl, and the short stack is now Tim as we get back to the felt.
Blinds continuing at 20 and 40,000 with a 5K ante.
Facebook.com/HPTFans, the place to find out about events before anybody else. Some bloopers and exclusive information about the HPT.
Tim folds, Daryl folds. We're over to Keith now.
Pocket deuces for Keith in the cutoff. And decides not to play.
Not even going to play it. Folded to you. A lot of players would have raised there, but at least call. Do some set mining.
Action's over to John with King Jack offsuit.
John, one of the casualties of poker's Black Friday. Back in April 15th of 2011, the internet blew up. No more online poker.
I cried for 4.5 days straight.
I know you did.
And then I went and had a steak.
John, one of the young guns that is making his transition into the live game. He's going to raise it up with King Jack offsuit to 105,000.
And now over to Gary in the big blind, Queen 10 of clubs. Definitely worth the price to see a flop here. And he will make the call out of the big blind, so we're heads up with Gary and John.
Two professional poker players. John will have position.
There is plenty of experience around the felt today. The flop is 9, queen, tray, rainbow.
And that's a good flop for Gary DiBernardi. He has hit top pair. John has a gut shot straight draw. Both players check.
The turn's a 5.
That's a brick. Gary's going to fire now.
120 is the bet for Gary. 120,000 from Gary. The 39-year-old from Bend, Oregon.
And John, with just a gut shot straight draw, lays it down, and Gary's going to win a nice size pot.
Debo will win his first pot here at our final table.
His active rail rooting him on.
Blinds continue at 20 and 40,000, $94,000 first place prize money here at Peppermill this week.
Darryl folds over to Keith. He's got ace seven of hearts.
Looks like he's ready to play, so let me get this straight. You're in the cutoff with pocket deuces, and you fold them, but now you're in middle position with A7 of hearts?
They're suited. Well, he is going to play it right. He's going to raise, even though it's not a very big raise. Makes it 100,000.
A6 of diamonds on the button for Jesse. He looks like he's taking note of that raise.
And he is going to go all in. The rail reacts.
Gary folds. Tim is going to fold. Action's back over to Keith.
And that A7 might as well be pocket deuces right now.
And he will fold. I'm telling you, Keith. Don't play the garbage. Play those pairs. That's how you make the money. But Jesse wins his first hand here at our final table. And Jesse's going to be looking for a nice parlay this week, turning this week's final table into buy-ins at the WSOP.
I'm Jesse Rockowitz. I live in Pacifica, California right now. I'm from Petaluma, California. I've played poker professionally for about 4 years now. April 15th this year was pretty rough year, a rough day. Before that, I was an online grinder playing between 20 and 30 tables of full ring cash. 94,000 is huge. I mean, especially with having money stuck online right now, it's definitely really, really helpful going into the World Series. It'll pay for a lot of my buy-ins for the World Series, a lot of my horses, buy-ins, etc. Play tight aggressive, try and take down pots uncontested if possible, run hot. Definitely good to be hot going into the World Series.
Right now, Jesse is second in chips, and he's closing in fast on Darryl. And we've got more poker to come from the Nevada State Poker Championship when we come back on the HPT. Thanks for coming back to the HPT, where we are still six-handed on our way to a $94,000 championship here tonight at the Peppermill Casino Resort Spa in Reno, Nevada.
You know, this week the Peppermill also opened their brand new poker room, and what an amazing room this is. To give us the insider tour of this $3 million gem, we sat down with poker room manager Mike Ganey.
From the start to finish, it was about for the construction of this room was about 6 weeks, and the cost was between $2.5 and $3 million. We have some of the best technology for the room. We have the Genesis Bravo system, which is the leader in the industry. We redesigned our poker tables. We got all new chairs. The chairs are like $800, $900 each. Very comfortable. We have the main room, which houses 13 tables, and we have a tournament or a high limit area in the back, which holds 6 more tables. Just about everything you could think of. We researched, we went down to some of the properties in Las Vegas and tried to pull the best from each property and put it back into here. And I think we came out with one of the nicest rooms I've ever seen. The games we offer here in the room, and no limit, we start off with a 1-2 blind, then we go to a 3-5. And a 5-10, and like yesterday we had a 10 and a quarter. We have Omaha on a daily basis, 4-8 limit with a half kill. We have Raz every Monday night, Crazy Pineapple every Thursday night. So we do whatever a player wants to play, I'll give it to him.
beautiful poker room, Fred, and the amount of money that you and I probably lost in rake, they probably got half that thing paid for already.
Yeah, they're doing all right. Here's the updated chip count. It is still all Daryl Dyer with just over 1.5 million in chips. The short stack is John Norberg with just 690,000.
John Bold, move over
to I'm not going to do it. I usually would, like...
Jesse's going to raise it up, makes it 90,000 to go with ace deuce.
Now you talk about the casualties of Black Friday. Jesse would play 20 to 30 tables at one time online. I'm telling you, Fred, no more internet poker is going to do wonderful things for people's attention span.
Well, a six-handed single table must seem pretty boring to him. For Keith, he woke up with wired fives, and this time he is going to play a small pocket pair. He's going to flat call the 90,000.
And so we will be heads up with Jesse and Keith. And here comes the flop. It's 10, king, 10 with two clubs.
Both players missed this flop. Keith has the best hand, but he's going to check over to Jesse.
105 is the bet.
Jesse is going to fire a continuation bet to 105,000. And Keith is playing a very tight and passive game right now. Folded pocket deuces a little bit ago. Flat calls the preflop raise here and does not lead out. And I suspect he's probably going to fold here.
And your suspect is correct. Keith will fold, and Jesse's going to win another hand. And he has now went up over a million in chips at this final table, second in chips. Also keep in mind, whoever wins here tonight will also get a seat at our year-end HPT Championship Open coming up at the end of Season 7 here at the beautiful Soaring Eagle Casino Resort in Mount Pleasant, Michigan.
Action has been folded around to Keith in the cutoff. It's Jack 3 offsuit. He gets it in the muck.
Over to John on the button with Ace 8. John with a lot of online experience, but his biggest live cash ever was just $2,000 in a live tournament.
Well, he is going to beat that record tonight. Looks like he is staging some raisin chips.
Indeed, he is going to raise with ace 8 offsuit. Makes it 105K.
Yes.
Raises to 105,000. And action is now on Gary, also with ace 8 in the big blind.
Gary's already in it for 40,000. It's only 75,000 to call, but he is going to re-raise it. Makes it 240,000 to go.
Now back to John.
John senses the re-steal, and he is going to go all in.
Telling you, Fred, more and more of these online players are going to make their way into the casinos. This is what we have to live with for the rest of our lives.
I'm just going to retire from poker now.
355,000 for Gary to call. That would be a good portion of his chips. And Gary is going to lay it down, and John wins a very nice pot with some very aggressive play from the button. Fred, let's meet another one of the players at the final table here tonight. This is Keith's first HPT event, but he's been watching us on TV for years.
Hey, my name is Keith Ryan. I'm from Reno, Nevada, and I'm a professional gambler. I primarily like to bet on the horses as well as play poker. And my secret to playing horses is probably my experience. That's probably why I play more horses than I do poker, because my grandfather used to play horses. I used to go to track with him. I learned to play horses at an early age, and I just fell in love with it. Yeah, this is my first HPT event, and I've always wanted to play. I watch you guys on TV all the time, and I was so happy when you guys came to Reno. This saved me the hotel and gas fare. I'm not going to be thinking about the money anymore. I'm going to try to take it down for Reno, because I think I'm the last person from Reno that's still in it. Little hometown, I'm going to represent my hometown, hopefully, take it down. I'm not trying for second anymore. I'm going to try for win.
Well, Keith is in the undesirable spot. He is the short stack here at our final table. We'll see if Keith can climb out of the cellar and make a run for the championship when we return to the HPT. Welcome back to the HPT this week in Reno, Nevada at Peppermill Casino Resort and Spa. Fred, we're still six-handed on our way to a $94,000 payday for one of the lucky six people still in our main event.
Earlier this week, we had over 500 players show up to help out Jen Harmon and the NSPCA. This event not only featured big names, it also featured a lot of big hands.
Oh, we're halfway there.
This nice lady and her friendly table mates were rooting for a five to pull from behind. She flopped a boat and then rivered quads.
You gotta let them muscle you around like that?
And what this gentleman lacked in guards, he had in luck.
Hey! And a flush! And a free roll! That's how it works. Get it in bad, people. You'll be all right on the flop.
And Daniel Negreanu took a psychic approach to the field.
Okay, I think I have queens.
Sorry.
I do not. I have a Doyle Brunson. There's your nine. Oh, you got the ace of hearts?
Well played.
Then the almighty hand made its rare appearance. Ladies and gentlemen, the royal flush.
In spades, no less.
Who's this? My girlfriend. Hi, how are you?
This is my girlfriend. What do you mean?
Really? Damn you.
Then the other co-founder of the HBT, the one who can play poker, Todd Anderson, enjoyed the company of ESPN's Lon McCarron.
I'm going to get you, Lon McCarron.
I call.
No.
Behind you.
Again.
Told you.
Don't put a six out there.
Oh!
You got her, man.
Better two pair.
First you take your girlfriend in the pot.
My girlfriend in your river?
You shouldn't have said anything.
Terrible. I don't believe I said that.
That's
you know, Lon is a great guy, and Fred, it's nice to see that even a big timer like Lon needs to get lucky every now and again. Fred, I know it's tough, but you cannot put a dog in your carry-on to bring home. I know you fell in love with about three different dogs we saw here this weekend. You can't take them home, Fred. Let someone from Nevada adopt them.
Oh, that's a good idea, but they are cute. And happy to say a lot of animals did get adopted at the Jen Harmon Throwdown event.
Daryl still our chip leader. Jesse in second place. Daryl will fold. Action is now on Keith. 6-4 offsuit. Is folded over to John. John folds over to Jesse. 25 years old from Pacifica, California.
And Jesse's going to go all in from the button with his suited ace eight.
Oh boy, an ace 10 from Gary.
This would be a tough call from Gary.
This would be for all of Gary's chips. Gary knows that his ace 10 is probably ahead, but it's tough to pull the trigger. Button could be just stealing the blinds. He could have absolutely nothing, or he could have a monster, but I'm betting Gary's thinking he's ahead right now.
Well, Gary is checking out the inventory. He finds that he does have him covered, and Gary is going to make the call.
Yep, I think he realized that he was probably going to be ahead with his ace 10. Put it up against a couple of random hands. Jesse's probably just doing what he should from the button, which is making a raise. And the flop is 3-deuce-deuce rainbow.
Interesting flop here. Gary fades the 8, but there are some chop-outs on this texture.
All right, here comes the turn. It is a 5.
Well, there is the chop-outs. Now, a 4 gives both players the wheel. A 3 or a 5 would give them both two pair with the ace kicker. Jesse needs to find an 8 on the river. He's going to double up Gary.
And the river is a 7, and so Gary plays the hunch that his ace 10 was ahead pre-flop. It was, and Fred after the hand, he's now freshly doubled up.
Big call from Gary DeBernardi here.
Thank you.
And he is going to reap the rewards as he is going to double up and become a contender for the championship. Blinds continuing on at 20 and 40,000 with a 5K ante.
Keith with King 7 of diamonds. He will fold.
John quickly folds over to Jesse. He lays it down.
Gary and his brand new chip stack. is going to raise it up with pocket sixes to 105,000. 5-8 offsuit for Tim. Over to Daryl with ace-eight of spades.
Well, the whole table just saw Gary make a huge call for his tournament life with ace-10. I have a feeling these players are going to step wisely around Gary now. Of course, as I say that, Daryl is stacking raising chips. It must be the hat.
The man doesn't like to call. He's only raising, and he makes it 225,000 with his suited ace. Back to Gary.
150,000 for Gary to call. We saw Gary make one big call. Does he want to make another call here to try to set mine and crack a bigger pair if that's what he has Daryl on? Or maybe he'll raise here to see how strong Daryl really is.
Doesn't it always seem when you finally get that double up you've been looking for, then you get involved in a big hand
usually,
right after
yep,
that?
Yep, exactly.
And Gary decides he is going to fold and pick a better spot than get tangled up with the chip leader.
Daryl continues to dominate, and we're still six-handed, but with that pot, he now has a third of the chips in play.
You know, Fred, there were a lot of celebrity poker players who were here this weekend at Peppermill, and when asked who they wanted to meet the most, the landslide winner was Daniel Negreanu. Now, Fred and James Larson had an opportunity to catch up with Daniel during Jennifer Harmon's Throwdown charity event.
This is a lot of fun. You know, I'm not really here to win. I'm here to help raise awareness, you know, for the NSPCA, which is a great charity, and also Jennifer Harmon's a good friend. If I didn't show up, she would absolutely smack me.
And you know what's so great about this event, though, is, you know, we expected a huge turnout, but looking around here, I mean, every table is full, the action is great, and we're having a good time.
Yeah, I remember playing this event a few years ago, and there was maybe like 50 or 60 people. There's almost 600 people here to raise money for the NSPCA, and that's just amazing, you know. And Jennifer's done a really good job, as has Lisa Wheeler and everybody else involved, the sponsors, in making this a fun event. You know, everyone who comes here really enjoys it. I busted a guy real early. He lost his 150 bucks. He says, it was the best 150 bucks I ever spent.
Sure.
So, that's the kind of experience we want people to walk away with when they come here.
Awesome, awesome. Well, you're the charismatic guy of poker. Now, do you still want to go by Kid Poker? Is that applicable yet?
Right? Well, you know, Kid Rock, what is he, like 50 now? Right,
yeah, you got a point.
So I'm thinking at some point in my life, I'd like to switch, and I'm thinking about Dan the Man. Does that have a good ring to it?
Dan the Man.
Right? Maybe I'll grow up. I've been doing the scruff, so maybe, you know, eventually we'll switch it up. But for now, Kid Poker works, because I feel 22.
Kid Poker and the rest of us are excited to see how this final table will play out, and more action from the felt when we come back. Welcome back to the HPT. It is time for our Pro Tip of the Week, featuring 2004 World Series of Poker Main Event Champion Greg Raymer. Tonight, Greg discusses what to do during a lull in your tournament play.
Now, when you play one of these big tournaments, frequently you play for a long time. I've been in tournaments where we start playing and we're not done for the day until like 14 or 15 hours later. Now, you're not going to play for 14 or 15 hours and be constantly in action, at least not if you're playing well. There's going to be lulls where you don't get to play a hand for a long time. How do you avoid a lack of concentration during this period? Well, the important thing is just to tell yourself that you are not here just to play your hands. You're here to observe these opponents. The best time to do that is when you are not in the hand. So when you get dealt rags and have to fold them pre-flop, that's great because it gives you more time to study your opponents objectively. You're not in the hand, you're not emotionally involved. You can be much more clear in your analysis, and you'll be amazed at the fantastic tells that you will pick up on players when you're not there playing the hand against them. Then when you do get dealt some good cards and you're seeing the flop against those guys, you'll know exactly how they do it, what they're doing, and what they're holding. And that means you're a lot more likely to win the money. So just think about all that money for first place, and I bet you won't get bored when you're in one of those tournament lulls.
Fred, I can tell you what I usually do during my tournament lulls. It's a tell that I have. It's eating chili fries.
Well, you eat all the time at the poker table, so you're just bored a lot. That's what that means. Daryl is still the chip leader with over 1.7 million in chips, has been in control all night long. Action in this hand will start on John. He's got connecting cards, 10-9.
They will be folded over to Jesse. From Pacifica, California, is all in.
It's ace nine for Tim West. Thinking about making this all-in call, it looks like.
I'm all in. And he's going to give Jesse some protection and go all in over the top of Jesse.
And unless it's pocket aces, Keith is folding, guaranteed.
So King 8 of Diamonds will go up against Ace 9 for Tim. Jesse's tournament life is on the line, and he's going to have to come from behind to stay alive.
Well, he's got two live cards, and he's got the suits.
That's Fred Bevel, the eternal optimist.
Nothing to celebrate for the Jesse fans on that flop. He still has running cards for straight or two live cards.
And the turn is another queen, putting some chop possibilities into play.
A queen or a jack will give both players a bow, but it killed the eight for Jesse. Now he's hoping for a king.
The river is a nine, and that will be it for Jesse Rockowitz. He will leave us today in sixth place.
You know, it was just a few moments ago. Jesse was second in chips, right on the heels of Daryl Dyer. This goes to show you, that's how quick things can change in a poker tournament.
Well, $16,000 in his pocket for his efforts today at our final table. And now Jesse is standing by with our floor director, James Larson.
All right, Chris and Fred, down here with Jesse. Nobody likes going out first at this final table, but you played great all weekend. It just came down to a couple hands ago where you got crippled. And talk about your play at the final table.
I didn't play many hands, raised a few, folded a few. Nothing went right.
It's kind of my standard line as I sit here with the person who goes out in sixth place. It's a good day because of the cash. You're going home with just over 15K, and I'm sure you can put that to good use.
Winning is good.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Fred, we are now five-handed at our final table, and earlier this weekend, Fred had the opportunity to sit down with yet another World Series of Poker champion, 2006 champ Jamie Gold.
Now, you came here to play the HPT. Tell me about the HPT experience for you.
I'm absolutely loving it. I think that what you've created is something that everybody has access to, where, you know, there are other tournaments, obviously, that might have been more famous, that have been around a lot longer, but the money that you have to spend just to get there and to buy into the tournaments, it keeps a lot of people out of these events. So it seems like you've created something that everyone in the country has access to.
You win in 2006, you pop up on high stakes poker and some other cash game shows like that, but really you've been kind of quiet in the poker world and people are like, where's Jamie Gold? You have a pretty good answer about where Jamie Gold has been. Tell me about your work with the UN.
A group that I'm a part of, it's called the Global Creative Forum. And we do a lot of work for the UN. And so we've been fortunate enough to have, you know, former President Clinton and Sean Penn and people like that go to Haiti on the UN's behalf, and we raise a lot of money, and they've allowed me to throw poker events to raise money for this cause. This group was started by Bill Ruana, who is the gentleman who created the Chicken Soup for the Soul series, and he's been extremely generous, and so it's people like him who have enough money to donate that if you get really bright people together, you figure out how you can affect change in the world, then you get somebody extremely famous to actually front it. We can really do something, you know, because I've raised a lot of money for a lot of causes, but half the time it doesn't feel like the money is really doing that much good. You know, you try to do what you can and you help people, but if you don't affect serious change, the world's not going to last a long time.
We'll look forward to having you at any event you want to come to.
Thank you.
Thanks for giving me some of your time today.
My pleasure.
Get back to that game. You're crushing.
Yeah, we got some good action back there.
The next person to leave our final table goes home with $19,000. The last person to leave, $94,000. More poker from our main event final table when we return. Welcome back to the HPT from Peppermill Casino Resort in Reno, Nevada. We're still five-handed, and the man who is leading the way is the very personable, very fun, yet dangerous, Daryl Dyer.
My name is Daryl Dyer. I am 24 years old, I'm from Sacramento, California, and I play poker for a living. Poker is a hobby that turned into a profession, didn't plan on playing it for a living. I love working out, I love painting, do watercolor. I'm on an indoor soccer team right now. Played five sports in my life, and poker is great because of, you know, competitive atmosphere, trying to win. There's room for improvement. You can move up the stakes. You know, it's everything that I want, but it's a game, and I love playing games, card games, every card game. My strategy to keep the chips is not to lose the chips, and to acquire more is to have the better hand than my opponent and have it hold up.
Genius! How do you get all of that on a bumper sticker?
That's a lot to compute there for you, Freddie. Here is the updated chip count. Daryl still our chip leader with 1.7, but Gary is right behind him at 1.3, and Tim also joins the Million Chip Club.
It is getting crowded in the chip stacks. Blinds are continuing on at 20 and 40,000 with a 5,000 chip ante.
Gary will fold 8-10 over to Tim.
Tim also with 8-10. He also folds over to Daryl. It's Jack 7 suited on the button. Daryl never saw a button he didn't like to lead out on. He is going to raise it up, makes it 85,000 to go. Keith Ryan looks down at King 6 of spades.
Keith's probably the tightest player at this table.
Might be the tightest player in poker.
Jack 9 of clubs for John in the big blind. John's from Yuba City, California. And he's going to make the call and see a flop together with Daryl. And the flop is 4-6 queen.
Swing and a miss. Right now, John is ahead with the bigger kicker.
He checks over to Daryl.
Daryl raises it up pre-flop. That opens the door for him to fire at this.
And if he does, it's a safe bet that John is going to fold the better hand here. 95,000 is the bet. Daryl, 9-5, right?
It was a cheap call for John to make out of the big blind, just hoping to connect something. He did not. And Daryl is going to add to his riches. Remember back in the day?
I love that.
Mets?
Yeah. You know what? If I had the chip lead, you can chant any darn thing you want. You see the hat I'm wearing? You see the chips I got? I'm in control, buddy. Action's folded back around to John. Ace five of clubs.
Fat guy breaks his neck trying to do cartwheel. Fat guy little coat.
Fat guy little coat. Been folded around to him. He's got a suited ace. It's a five-handed game. What does all that equal to you?
Raise it up.
We might want to keep our voices down. I think John heard us. He is going to raise it up, makes it 105,000 to go.
Now, if they're taking our advice at the poker table, that could be their first problem. And Gary's going to fold, so now action over to Tim in the big blind.
Like eight-ish? Yeah. Nine. How many blues do you have? An extra blue?
I got three stacks.
Three stacks of blue?
Three. One.
I have no blues in front of me. I have no orange. I just have a Fred, and he's just sitting to my left.
Yeah, dead money is Fred.
King 9, after all that for Tim, quickly gets thrown to the muck. A lot of professional poker players in the room this week. I mean, really, you could swing Daryl's hat around and hit five or six of them without even trying. 20 and 40,000 still the blinds with a 5K ante. That's probably going to be the last hat. No, that won't be the last hat joke throughout the day.
Fred. I know you too well. It will not be. Well, he was deliberating calling a raise with King 9. Now it looks like he is going to open this pot with King 6. He's going to make it 95,000 to go.
Daryl folds. Over to Keith. Keith into this event on a $120 satellite.
Well, he is proving that tight is indeed right. He made it all the way to this final table. He's folded some hands that a lot of people would have played, but he's moving up the money ladder.
Pocket 9s for Gary. Got some buddies in the crowd who are having a very good time watching their friend play at the final table.
Gary getting frisky with the nines is going to shove them all in, putting the pressure on Tim. This will be for all of his stack. And that's two hands in a row that Tim West has had to raise and then fold to a re-raise.
More poker when we come back on the HPT. Welcome back to the HPT from Peppermill Casino Resort Spa in Reno, Nevada. I'm Chris Hansen, and he owes me $50.
That's true. I'm sorry. I'll get it.
I could use it.
You know, a lot of fun was had this week by all, and one of the highlights was Jennifer Harmon's Throwdown Celebrity Charity event to benefit the NSPCA.
Lou Diamond Phillips wasn't the only one who got some love from AJ Lamas. AJ was feeling the love and goodwill in the room and wanted to spread it around. And the love continued with ESPN's Lon McCarron and HPT co-founder Todd Anderson.
They went away. They're coming home now. They're back.
You're not going to name these, right? Because they're just temporary.
I never named any. Well, let's see. We got George Jr.
Oh, yeah.
George Jr. Jr.
The biggest hand from Team HPT was between HPT co-founder Greg Lang and Kathy Liebert for an autographed Elton John guitar.
Kathy Liebert has just won a guitar signed by Elton John and the band.
That's pretty sweet.
We give Greg Lang a round of applause. He put all his stack in there.
What are you going to do? Elton John guitar, you got to shove him in.
But don't you worry, Greg wasn't lonely on the rail for long.
All about position. Position, very important. If you would have stayed as dealer, if I could have kept Ernie around, I might have been able to win this thing. But unfortunately, they tapped you out. But overall, we raised a lot of money for a great cause.
One of the better players, I got to admit.
Yeah, one of the better players. I tipped the best. Even in a tournament, I tipped the best.
Then my favorite knockout of the day was my partner and close friend, Chris Hansen.
The first one I might have seen all day. Please tell me I'm live. You might be live. I'm live.
You shoved with A7, which is surprisingly strong for you.
You weren't too far behind me there, Mr. Card Shark.
Straight over straight? What?
Go on, my friend.
Keep the loose juice flowing.
Fred's out now. You can yell at him.
Am I chipping a chair? Have a good day, guys.
As the blinds climbed higher, Team HPT members started dropping like honeybees in a smoker. But a lot of fun was had and a lot of money was raised to help the unadopted animals and the no-kill shelters of the great state of Nevada.
The last man standing from Team HPT was everyone's favorite, HPT Tour Ambassador and good friend, Darvin Moon. Well, things aren't going very good for Keith. His tight play has found him in the short stack. Things are going very well for Daryl Still at this final table.
Blinds are now 30 and 60,000 with a 5,000 chip ante.
A6 for John. Over to Gary. King 6. Like mucked. 5-3 from Tim goes to the muck, and now we're up to the blinds. The big stack and the short stack. 10-3 of spades. Daryl is all in, trying to change something. I see Keith has now got sunglasses on. And Keith is going to fold, and even though he's now wearing sunglasses that appear to be see-through, everything is just not going his way. He's playing very tight, and Freddie, he's not really getting the cards either, though.
Well, and Daryl made that shove knowing that there was only one or two hands that Keith would call that with, and all these players are picking up on that tight image. Daryl this time wakes up with my favorite hand, mom and dad, king, queen, and he's going to raise it up under the gun.
138 players. It was one of the deep stack universities.
And he makes it 125,000. Over to Keith.
Great turn.
A7.
Keith did not see that coming.
Well, Fred, I had a feeling that Keith looked down, saw that ace, went all crazy in the head, and decided it's time to put them all in the middle. A couple other aces have folded behind him.
I call.
Daryl is going to make the easy call, only 265,000 more, and for Keith, it's not all bad. You're ahead. Daryl's got two live cards.
Here comes the flop. It's 6-5-4.
Good flop for Keith. He was ahead, but now he's flopped an open-ended straight draw to just shut the door and double up here.
And the turn is a jack.
Keith just needs to fade the king or the queen, and he will double up.
The river. Oh, the river's a queen. And just like that, Keith thinks he's going to be doubling up and now finds out he's going to be leaving the final table.
Keith had the double up in his hands until the river. Harold Dyer continues to dominate and run well. And with that pot, he now has $2.5 billion of the $5.7 in play.
Well, $19,000 is going to have to be the bad beat medicine for Keith. He's standing by back down to the floor with James.
Thanks, guys. Joined with Keith going out in fifth place, going home with just over $18,000. Now, you went in there on the short stack with the ace, and you actually had a pretty nice flop.
Yeah, I wanted to get my money in good, and I have no complaints. It's been a great tournament.
And with this money, you told me in the pre-interviews that you like betting the horses, so I have a feeling there's going to be some trifectas in your future.
Yeah, I hope so. Yeah.
Thanks so much, Keith. He's going home in fifth place with just over $18,000. Chris and Fred, we'll send it back to you.
Thank you very much for playing this weekend, Keith, and good luck at the track.
You think he'd give us some picks?
I don't see why not. Fred, we are four-handed now with that elimination here at our final table. Now, do you think you've got what it takes to sit at our final table and win the unreal cash? Well, then log on to hptpoker.com to find out about upcoming events in your backyard. For James Larson and Fred Bevel, I am Chris Hansen. We'll see you next time right here on the HPT.